I really think the people are what makes Stony Brook unique.
We've had a lot of fun, whether it's studying, whether it's celebrating after an exam, whether it's just trying to plan life.
I would say that it's not just that we're friendly, that we inspire each other to be the best that we can be.
I wanted to come back to Stony Brook to be on the faculty because of the incredible experience I had as a medical student.
A lot of the curriculum isn't just, you know, the faculty spewing facts and you taking those in. A lot of it is very interactive. It's case-based where we talk about stuff.
I think most students, they come to med school not to be in the classroom and have those lectures, but they want the clinical experience. And in the past few years, we instituted the LEARN curriculum.
To give our students more time on the wards and more time to figure out what they want to do.
This curriculum compresses the basic science and the preclinical years into a year and a few months.
It affords them with a lot of time to explore different specialties so that they can be assured that they've selected the specialty that works best for them.
Getting those hours in, working with patients, working with colleagues is the best way to prepare yourself for residency.
There is the medical center and there's the health sciences center, and they are both connected so that I can do all of my academic studies, my degree work in one building, but it's immediately connected to physicians and people that I could reach out to directly to do research with or study with or further my education to get certain experiences that I wouldn't be able to get if it was just a standalone health sciences center.
The new medical and research translation building. There are opportunities for students to get involved in clinical research, translational research, basic science research.
Many of our students take advantage of the scholarly concentration program where they have a dedicated track of time to do research.
The students can kind of tailor their interests to what kind of scholarly concentration they like to pursue.
Global health, clinical research, bench research, research in medical education, and research in compassionate care and the ethics of medicine as well.
There's residents who have projects that they're always looking for students for. There's faculty and PhDs who are usually looking for students as well. Some of it requires your own initiative to reach out. If you hear of something cool going on, you're welcome to kind of reach out to the PI and say you'd really love to get involved.
You can lead the projects or you can just be involved as these things happen.
The students have a lot of flexibility in kind of picking out what path they want to take.
In our fourth year, we do something called a sub-internship where you're treated as a resident. You're putting in the orders. You are speaking to patients as if you are their resident. You are the ones making plans. You're writing the notes. So you are like a pseudo-resident, and that really gives you exposure here. And there's so much support.
We actually function almost as an intern. Obviously, there's oversight, but we go through the steps of what it would be like to be an intern.
There are multiple opportunities outside of the classroom learning to shadow in the different fields or do research. I never turn down a student who wants to come shadow me in the operating room or in the clinic. Anyone who contacts me, I'll let them come watch me because I do feel it's very important that they learn what the fields are about.
There are a lot of venues for the students to find mentors. For example, for women in medicine, there's a women in science and medicine program where I mentor several students through that capacity, as well as through my clinical rotations.
We're looking for a person who's done well academically, but also brings other things to the table.
I have two young children at home, both of which I had during medical school, and I'm getting a dual degree, an MD and PhD degree.
An MD PhD program is a combined degree program where the PhD is actually integrated into your medical education. The uniqueness of this degree is that you not only can practice medicine and take care of patients, but you can really identify problems and apply scientific thinking and scientific methods into solving those questions. We actually have NIH funding, so it's a medical scientist training program. The real advantage of the graduate programs here are the availability of Brookhaven National Lab as well as Cold Spring Harbor.
Diversity of life experience, diversity of just culture is important. I think all those things actually help to make Stony Brook better.
I think if you were to look at my transcript, I would not be your science major because I took everything from anthropology, philosophy, kind of all those different courses.
It helps us to learn from each other in a way that helps elevate Stony Brook.
We have a lot of faculty that are just amazing, people that you really want to be like.
Medicine is truly a team sport. You know, when we go through medical school, we're still an individual. But as we get into the clerkships, as we get into our clinical lives, it really is about the team.
I think it's great for the students to be able to see the way we all work together and enjoy working with our colleagues in all different fields.
If you have any questions at all, we can email the deans even up to the deans. We can email them. We can even just walk up to their office if you have any questions about courses, if you have any concerns about careers. We're able to just go up to their office and talk to them about any concerns that we have.
We have a formal advising system that spans all 4 years of medical school. In addition, our faculty and our administration have open door policies, and students are made to feel very comfortable to come and speak to us about whatever may be on their mind.
As you enter medical school, every first year student is assigned what we call pods. This is a group of, you know, all 4 class years students, where we get together usually on a monthly basis to talk about any questions or concerns.
One of our classmates started a grand big program where us fourth years are paired with the incoming first years.
The science you learn from a textbook, from the classroom, the art you learn from your mentors, from your professors.
When you look at Suffolk County, we're about 1.6 million people. So we're the size of Metro Boston, but we're the only academic medical center.
We're a level 1 trauma center, which is really exciting because that means we get to see a lot of diversity.
Patient population is very diverse. The variety of cases you see are very diverse.
Level 1 trauma center, level 1 stroke center, level 1 myocardial infarction center. We have all of the specialties that anyone could possibly need for clinical care.
From the ED to the floors, we see everything from really acute cases being rushed in. We also have a mobile stroke unit program, which is very unique and new, to cases that are more chronic.
Really will allow them, one, to figure out what type of population they'd like taken care of. It's going to give them access to pathology that they just won't see.
So SB Home is our student-run clinic.
The clinical managers at the front desk are students. The people taking your vitals are students. My favorite spot is in the back in the laboratory doing blood draws. Those are all by students.
Provides a great space for students to get some clinical experience outside of what they learn in the classroom. Having other students that also understand the importance of giving back on top of what they do for school gives the students some motivation.
I think it's one of the few schools that really take the student feedback and change for you. And that was very visible through the COVID-19 crisis that we had.
Our students have great input into their own education. We actually listen.
So our student government is pretty broad. We have at least 10 different subcommittees, whether it's curriculum, honor code, but we also have fun things like social chair, sports, and other extracurriculars.
There's interest groups for all of the specialties that you could think of, and if there isn't one, you can start one.
It's not just the medical school. Having the entire medical center here, the other health science schools, having the undergraduate campus here is a really unique thing. I've worked with the computer science people across campus. I've worked with the business school across campus. I've worked with the public health school. The opportunity between what we call our East and West campus and the opportunity from a research perspective are very unique.
Students coming now in 2020 and beyond have the benefit of learning in our new hospital classrooms, our beautiful new research labs, our state-of-the-art hospital wing.
The university offers many extracurricular activities, including D1 athletics, a new state-of-the-art recreational center where students can exercise and take classes in spin cycling and yoga, a fine art center that showcases national and international performers, and a fantastic film series 3 times a year.
I love the beaches. I love the towns that you can visit and the restaurants that you can find. There's hiking. There's vineyards.
Go to New York City.
There's great museums. There's lots to do on Long Island.
Community is important to help support people through the ups and downs. You don't want to be alone in medicine. So building those ability to have relationships with your colleagues is really important.
It's really great to feel supported and to have faculty and administration who do care about you.
They're really, really great, and I feel really blessed to be here.
Our students are extremely well prepared.
A large number of our students match at the most competitive programs around the country.
They are now attending physicians at places like Cornell, Columbia, University of Pennsylvania, all Johns Hopkins, all these high-profile institutions. And they're generally very well regarded by their peers, and it's a very gratifying experience to know that they started here.
Students who graduate from Stony Brook, if I take myself as an example, have a huge amount of opportunities. You're so prepared with the kind of education that you get here, with the network that you can develop.
Stony Brook did a really excellent job of training us.
Stony Brook has given us a lot, and we're ready to do more with it.